Good morning students, welcome to today's class. So last class I have explained you about chapter 4 advanced features of MS Word. So in that I have explained you about track changes features, accepting and rejecting track changes, thesaurus features, then how you can insert and delete comments, and that I have explained. So today I will explain you about hyperlink and mail merge. So children, while watching the video, you must keep your books and notebooks with you, and you must keep one pencil along with you, because in that activity only, in that video we will do the activity, I will tell you the answers. By watching the video you can do the activity along with me. So let's begin chapter 4 advanced features of MS Word. So last class I have told you inserting and deleting comments. Now turning off track changes. So if you are using a tablet computer, you can add voice comments to a document instead of typing comments in the comment value. So if you are using a tablet computer, you can add voice comments to a document instead of typing comments in the comment balloon. Now turning off track changes. How you can turn off the track changes? So when we turn off the track changes option on the way, we can turn it on. The steps to do is click on the review tab. Clear? Click on the review tab, then click on the track changes arrowhead button to select the track changes option. So in MS Word you have to click the review tab, then you have to underline that, click on the review tab, click on the track changes arrowhead button to select the track changes option. The button color will change to back to normal, implying that the option has been turned off. So it will change to the normal, that implies that option has been turned off. When we turn off track changes feature, all the changes that have been tracked remain in the document and do not get removed. So when we turn off the track changes feature, all the changes that have been tracked remain in the document, they do not get removed. Now next is hyperlink. So inserting hyperlink, take out your book, open page number 43. So hyperlink, you must be knowing the colored or underlined text or picture, that is hyperlink. So in the previous class we have learned that hyperlinks help us to move quickly from one page to another by simply clicking on it. A hyperlink may be in the form of some text or picture. Hyperlink may be in the form of text or picture, the mouse pointer. The mouse pointer changes to a shape of hand. So the mouse pointer changes to a shape of hand. So in hyperlink, the mouse pointer changes to a shape of hand. The mouse pointer changes to a shape of hand symbol when pointed over a hyperlink. Suppose you are pointing over a hyperlink, the mouse pointer changes to a shape of hand. So this is the mouse pointer hand symbol when pointed over a hyperlink. To insert a hyperlink, we have to follow the steps. First, suppose this is a document you have written. So you have to select the required text, like this text, you have to select the required text. How to select the text? By holding the mouse and dragging. In the links group on the insert tab. In the links group on the insert tab, this is insert tab. So in the links group on the insert tab, select the hyperlink button. Now select the hyperlink button. This will open insert hyperlink dialog box. Now this will open insert hyperlink dialog box. Now you can see here link to. This will open this insert hyperlink dialog box. In the link to, you can see link to box is here. This is link to box. In the link to section, select existing file or web page button. So here existing file, you have to select this existing file or web page button. Clear? So you have to select existing file or web page button. Now in the link in section, now this is link in section, this red color box. In the link in section, click any of these three buttons. Like three buttons are given: current folder or recent files or browse pages. So click any of these three buttons and select a file or web page from the right pane. Select a file or web page from the right pane, then enter the URL. URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator of the linked file address. URL means address of the linked file or web page in the address box. So in the look in, you will select the existing file with the page button. Now third step, in the look in section, click any of these three buttons and select a file or web page. Now click any of these three buttons and select a file or web page from the right pane to enter the URL. So this step, third step, we have done. Click any of these three buttons you can see. So select a file or web page from the right pane or enter the URL. URL means address of the linked file or web page in the address box. The selected text will turn to a hyperlink. Now you can see that there is a blue color. So the selected text will turn to a hyperlink. Now remember, to use the hyperlink inserted in a document, open the document in full screen reading view. Suppose you want to, what is a hyperlink? The underlined or colored text is known as hyperlink. While searching information from the internet, when you must have seen different types of colored text, children. So these are known as hyperlink. When you point to that text, the shape of the mouse change to a hand symbol. So the mouse pointer generally takes the shape of the hand symbol when pointed over a hyperlink, underline or colored text. I have shown you. The first step, links group. From the insert tab, select hyperlink button, then click link to option, then select the existing file of the web page, then look in, click any of these three buttons, select a file or web page from the right pane or enter the URL, then click on the OK button. Now remember, to use the hyperlink inserted in a document, open the document in full screen reading view and click on hyperlink. The link document will open. In all other views, you will have to press control key. In all other views, you have to press control key, then click the hyperlink to open the link document. To use hyperlink inserted in a document, I have shown you how. Suppose open the document in full screen reading view and click on hyperlink. The link document will open in all other views. Not reading view, and all other views, you will have to press control key, then click the hyperlink to open the linked document. Now one activity is given in page number 43. So children, take out your pencil or pen and write the answer. Answer this questions: which features allows you to find synonyms of a word in a document? So what is the answer? The answer is thesaurus. Thesaurus feature allows us to find synonyms of a word in a document. Children, you can write the answers in the notebook as well for practice. You can practice these answers. Which tab will you open to insert hyperlinks in a document? Insert tab we will open to insert hyperlink in a document. Third one, which tab will you open to access the track changes features? Review tab we will open to access the track changes feature. Fourth one, which key will you use to open hyperlink in print layout view? Control key. we will use control key to open hyperlink in print layout view. Again, I am repeating. First one is thesaurus, second one is insert tab, third one is review tab, fourth one is control key. So which feature synonym thesaurus, which tab insert hyperlink, insert tab, which tab will open you to access track changes feature, that is review tab, which key you will use to open hyperlink in the print layout view, that is control key. Now next is mail merge. Page number 43 only, what is mail merge? Suppose you want to write an invitation letter to invite to your friends to your birthday party. So you have 50 friends, so you have to write 50 times. No, you also want the that each other, each letter should contains friend's name and address along with the standard invitation text. Then the content should be same, but your friend's name and address may be different. So how to do that one? Using mail merge, you can see this box, how many tabs are here: file, home, insert, design, page layout, reference, mailings, start mail merge, then letters, email, messages, envelope. How to do mail merge, I will explain you now. So how will you do it? If you attempt to create all these letters manually, it will take hours. Suppose you have 50 friends you want to invite, it will take hours. However, it will take only a few minutes if you do it using the mail merge feature of MS Word. So mail merge is very important feature of MS Word. So mail merge, mail means letter, merge means joining. Like one letter has been written, it will join with the student's name and address. That's why it is known as mail merge. So mail merge is a feature that allow us to merge a document file, means where you have written the text, main topic, that I am inviting you in my birthday party or something, that containing the standard text with a data source. Data source means that file contains name and address of the recipients, your all friends' name and address. To create multiple personalized copy, it will create multiple, means many personalized copies. So that is mail merge feature. So what is mail merge feature? Turn the page number 44. So clearly all the mail merge process consists of two types of file. First one, already the main document file that has text that is common to all the letters, like text that is for everyone, you will write the same date and address, date and place. So that is the main document file. Next is the data source file that contains data to be merged with the main document. Here address list file is the data source that contains the address of your friend. It contains the address of your friends. The procedure for doing mail merge is very simple and involves the following step. So the procedure for doing mail merge is very simple and it involves the following steps. First get the main document contents the text to be sent to the all the recipients. First write the main document that contains the text to be sent to the all the recipients. Create a list of recipients that will contain the data of all the recipients whom you want to invite. So create a list of recipient. Now, suppose you want to invite some students. So you make a list every time whenever in your birthday party, you make a list. So create a list of recipient that will contain the data of all the recipient. Insert the data fields and the required location in the main document. Insert the data fields and the required location in the main document. And now merge both the document. The merged letters will be ready. So first you have to write the main letter, then in another file you have to write their address whom you want to send the letter, address and name. Insert the data fields with the letter, then merge both the document. The merged letters will be ready. About mail merge. So mail merge procedure, the procedure for doing mail merge is very simple and it involves the following steps. Merge both the document. The merge letters will be ready. Now see here, dear name, address, city, you have been selected to participate in the debate competition to be held on the 15 June. That is main document with text. This is the main document with text. So this is main document. Now data list. Now Arjun, address 125, sector 5, Chandigarh. Then all the address, all the students address has been written over here. Clear? You can see everyone's address over here. This is data list. This one is data list. All the students' data, and this is main document. Now both have been merged together. The main document, you can see both have been merged together. Now this is the letter. Dear Arun, sector 5, Chandigarh, you have been selected. Dear Mithesh Kumar, then one participant, three. The mail merge letters. These are the mail merge letters. So three letters has been created by combining main document text and data list. So merge both the document. The merge letters is ready. So in this way you can create mail merge process. So doing mail merge, how to do mail merge? Next class I will explain you how you can do mail merge step by step procedure. Everything I will explain you next class. How you can do mail merge. So today I will explain you track changes, features and all those things. Next class I will explain you about mail merge steps. So that's all for today. So students, now I will explain you how you can use thesaurus and track changes features, accepting, rejecting changes and adding comments to a suggestion. So first, this you have to open a Word document. I have opened a Word document. Now the document has been opened. Now I want to find the synonym, or synonym means thesaurus means to finding the synonyms. So I want to find the synonym of this word attribute. First I will select, then I will go to review tab. You can see different tabs are there. Click on the review tab. The review tab is clicked. Now I have clicked here review tab. Now I will click on the thesaurus button. I will go to click on the thesaurus button in the proofing group. You can see the thesaurus button is this one. So click on the thesaurus button. Now see, I have selected the word attribute. Now see, the synonyms of attribute are this. Now the synonyms of attribute are this: quality, characteristic, feature, point, power, except, element, part, property. So these are the synonyms of attribute. I have selected that word, and these are the synonyms of attribute. Now next is track changes feature. How you can apply track changes feature in Word document? So first you have to open the document which you are reviewing. Go to review tab, then click on the track changes drop down button. So select the track changes drop down button. Now I want to, from that menu, select the track changes option, and the button will become highlighted indicating that track changes feature has been turned on. Now make the required changes through the document. Now I want to make any changes to this document. Here, make the required changes. Suppose I want to change this one or something, so it will appear like this. Now again I want to cut this one, so it will appear like this. So in this way you can apply track changes feature in MS Word. Now
in this way you can use track changes feature. Now you can accept and reject the track changes feature. Suppose you want to accept or reject the track changes feature, click on the review tab. Now you can see this button. Now this is accept. Suppose I have accepted. You have to click if you want to accept the track changes feature. Now reject. I have rejected. Next. Next one. Next one also I have rejected. See. Next one, reject. I have rejected. Next one, reject.